And good morning. It's Friday the 30th of December 2016. A little rare, a very, very rare morning live chat show for you this morning, boys and girls. Thought we'd try it live for a change. Lots of people with us already. Good morning to Wendy. Now, Wendy is with us this morning. She is very, very excited. Very excited because she has just had one of her tweets liked by the great Tony Blackburn. We must get down on two knees when we say his name. Just a moment. We must... Oh, there's not many people I get down on two knees for these days. But Tony Blackburn, and of course, the great Barry Manilow is one of them. Tony Blackburn is definitely one of them. And Wendy Young has just made some sort of... I don't know what the comment was, actually. Has made some sort of comment on Tony Blackburn's tweetings... Tweet. I'm not a tweet person. I'm really not. I do have a Twitter account, but I rarely use it. Wendy has had some sort of tweet like, so we must find out what that is. Now, a similar thing happened to me with not only the same person. Oh, yes. Yes, it was a few months ago, and I can't remember what it was, but I tweet. Oh, yeah, yes, I do remember. On this show, I don't know if Tony watches this show. Wouldn't it be marvellous if Tony Blackburn is actually watching this? Perhaps Barry Manilow watches this show. You don't know. You never know who's watching. Who's watching? Or if you've now got an Amazon Echo, you never know who's listening. Oh dear, we're not having one of those in the house. Thank you very much. My mate's just got one of those. He's got the smaller one, the Amazon Dot. I think it's called the Amazon Dot, which looks, it's much smaller than the Amazon Echo. Whether or not it does exactly the same thing, I'm not sure. I have a feeling it's just the sound quality wouldn't be as good because you've got a smaller speaker in there, I'm assuming. But I don't know if it does everything the Amazon Echo. Well, I don't even know what the Amazon Echo can do. I know if you want to know the time. Amazon Echo, could you tell me the time? Oh, no, what do you have to call? Alexia. Perhaps you've got one now. I wonder... If you've got an Alexia set up in your... No, an Amazon Echo set up or an Amazon Dot set up in your house, could I set it off? I think the code word that Amazon says you have to use is Alexia. So if you've got an Amazon Echo somewhere and I say, Alexia, what is the weather going to be like today? OK, would it set off your one? And would it then tell me what the weather is? It can tell you the weather. It can, one of the things that I think is nice about it is that it can read you an audio book. Now, I don't know if you're like me, but I get bored reading. I open the book, and I've said this so many times before, and I like books. But I open it, you know, it might be so thick, mightn't it? And I get that far. And then all I see is that lot of pages waiting to be read. I don't see the story. Do you see what I'm saying? I would never have found out what happened to poor Harry Potter, dear. You know, if I'd have had to read the books. But the Amazon Echo can read these things too. I know you can already do that, can't you? You can download audio books onto iPhones and MP3 players and stuff like that. But this Amazon Echo, you just say, read me. Let's think of something really nice to go fall asleep to. Read me. Read me The Shining. That's what we need. A few knifings in the morning. That's what we need. So the Amazon Echo. Has anyone got an Amazon Echo? And have I just set it off? Alexia, who is Chris Reardon? I mean, you'd be there all day with that one, wouldn't you? Yes. Let me do some messages. Good morning this morning, to, as I say, to Wendy. I want to ask you something about the tweets in a minute. Good morning to Adam. Adam the plumber's with us. Vectis is on the Isle of Wight listening while at work. Are you on the bins today? Is there a little radio in your car? Have you got an internet radio in your car, Vectis? Good morning, Vectis. Shania, lovely daughter of Vectis, says good morning. Did you hear? I commented on your programme yesterday. Very warm. Vectis and Shania, they do little video shows as well. Vectis is on the radio station on the Isle of Wight. Very warm people. Warm. Not like watching Towie. You would never see people like Vectis and Shania on something like the Jeremy Kyle show. Oh, no, no. They'd be Bake Off, you see. They'd be Bake Off. My sister would be Jeremy Kyle. They would... Vectis, I can see Vectis. Well, they wouldn't be on Bake Off, not since they shut it off the Channel 4. It won't be the same there, dear. It's all very well. For some reason, moving stuff from BBC One in full colour, incidentally, you know, onto Channel 4 or ITV, it doesn't, it rarely works. I don't think it's ever worked. They did it with Morecambe and Wise, didn't they? Even Morecambe and Wise, that didn't work over there. Who else? There was quite a few things that happened to. Anyway, let's go back to this. So, very warm programs they do. If you want to find out a little bit more about them, have a look through my friends list. I don't hide anything on here. Okay, have a look for the friend list. Look up Vectis Humpty or Shania Steele on my friends list, and there you'll find links to their little videos that they do. Very, 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 very warm and nice. Good morning to Carl. Morning, Carl. Are you at work today, dear? Come on. Chop, chop, 10 o'clock, get to work, dear. Good morning to Anne Taplin. Hello, Anne. How are you? Look, it's up, dear. It's up. Oh, and I did DIY yesterday, boys and girls. DIY here in the Mirrorball Studios. Look, the other one's back up there. What I might do, because I'm noticing the lights. I've got two great big lights here. And I'm wondering if I move them, can you see certain things reflect? Actually, that's all right. That doesn't reflect, but certainly the top of the Barry calendar does, unless I do that, and then it doesn't reflect, and that's reflecting a bit as well. It might be my Christmas star of what we need. Should we move the star up here a bit? Star of wonder, star. Oh no, that's going to collapse, isn't it? So I did DIY yesterday. Oh, yes, I had the nail and the hammer out, and it's up there. Not sure how long it's going to be stay there. You don't really want me. I've got shelves in front of me here where there's a monitor. Two cameras. There's actually two cameras in front. I'd say cameras. One's an iPhone. That's the one I'm recording on. That's for the recorded version of this show. And the other one's the live camera there. For when the live bit's finished, it's always better to have a different camera doing the recording because the quality is so much better. And I've got that on shelves, and that fell down the other day. One of these fell, this one here fell down the other day. All I did was I just touched it, and the entire thing collapsed on the floor on top of my wires and things like that down there. Yes, dreadful, dreadful. Good morning, Claire Norton. Good morning, Claire. Morning, Claire. Morning to Antonio in Italia. Ciao bello. Ciao bello. Antonio says, I like Chris because he is a man. I don't know about that, dear. He is a man that has always something to tell you. People are not talking anymore. Oh, well, we know that, don't we, Antonio? They sit there, tap, 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 tap. I was working last night in a place in Clapham called the Two Brewers, where I do every Thursday night. It was actually a very nice night. I played lots of Wham. Like I played lots of Wham and George Michael and other dead people thank them for their wonderful music. You know, I grew up with the whole Wham thing. David Bowie, I played lots of David Bowie last night, and some others. Who else did I play? The man from Dead or Alive. Well, I can't remember his name now. I played some of him last night, and there was another one. Who was the other one now? Can't remember now. But I was going through the list of the wonderful, wonderful people that we've lost, and I played lots of those last night, which went down very well. Lovely night last night, actually. Although it was 3 o'clock finish, and I went, oh, I got that. And I got in the car. I'm in that car at 2 minutes past. I'm telling you now. But you know when people shout, one more, one more? They don't get one. Not for me, dear. I'm tired. The job is done. No one's being paid overtime. What do you mean, one more? I say, oh, you're a spoil sport. Or worse words than that. Worse words than that they use to your poor little Chris. They do. Spoil sport. I say, not words. Actually, they don't even use those words. Terrible words they use as I walk out the door. And I'm thinking, I bet you don't do any overtime, do you? You know? Are you a bus driver or something like that? You know, 12 o'clock, 12 o'clock. 1 o'clock, you're gone, ain't you? 1 minute past, and I'm the same. 2 minutes past three, I'm in that car, tearing out of London, although I couldn't tear out of London last night because it was very thick fog. Well, actually, London wasn't too bad. But on the A3, it started there, and then I kind of, instead of going on the main M3 on the way home, if I'm in Clapham, I'll go A3, M25, and then there's a road that goes through a lovely little place called Chobham, which is not too far from me, and I kind of come round the back, because if I go on the M3, number one, there's a 50 mile an hour speed limit on there, which is bad enough. But they've, because of the roadworks there, and this is still not finished yet, I think it's next December it finishes. They've got this concrete thing separating the hard shoulder from the rest of the road. The thing is, it's not lit up and it's grey and there's no reflectors or anything on there. And you always think that you're closer to it than you really are. Do you know what I mean? Do you know those things I mean? It's not like, there are some plastic versions of this, which are like red and white and red and white, and they're so obvious to see. But these great big concrete things are just grey, and you cannot see them properly. I think they're very, very dangerous things, those. I mean, they're obviously there to separate the traffic from the workforce that you rarely see out there. Oh, no, they'd close the entire motorway, you know, as one bloke changing a light bulb. There he is. You know, he gets halfway up the ladder, lights up a fag. Right, tea break now. It's one of those, I think, something like that. But I really don't like those grey things in the road. And I find them a bit scary. So I go round the other way through Chobham. Lovely, lovely quiet road, which is near Woking, which actually is where Anne, I've just outed where you live, Anne. Anne lives in a large mansion in Woking. Oh, beautiful place, it. You know, massive driveway Anne lives down. If you set out, it's her driveway to the front door is 3 miles long. Unbelievable. You know, she's got staff working for her. She don't have to do anything. She just pushes a button and a meal arrives. Isn't that marvellous? She's got a whole lot of stuff. Anne, she's on here now. Anne Taplin, talk to her if you want to. You know, very, very rich and big houses. And, you know, she's one of those people. One of those people. Well, I think I'll go out today. What car shall I take? One of those. Oh, yes, yes. Lovely lady. Does her shopping in Waitrose. Same as me. Does her shopping in Waitrose. Now, where were we now? Oh, yes, we're talking about the road. So I come through Chobham. Now, I like Chobham. And I typed in the other day on Rightmove, which is like an online estate agency type thing. And I typed into there, you know, houses for sale. And it asks you how much you from and to, how many bedrooms, that sort of thing. And I just put in any bedrooms and I put up to £500,000, like £500,000. I pushed enter, nothing. Honestly, not even a small flat. There was nothing in Chobham less than £500,000. Unbelievable. I mean, I don't know how the children are going to buy anything if they want to live then near their parents. Won't be able to buy anything, will they? Mind you, do you always want to live near your parents? I don't know if you do or not, really. I mean, I know parents, they get very upset when you leave the house. They do, when you get your own place. I remember my mum, I mean, I don't know why. I think you want your own place, don't you? And when, I mean, I was married once, so that was once, and that didn't work, funnily enough. So I came back again and then stayed for, a few years. And then I bought my own place in Wandsworth. And when I moved out, and Mum was quite upset then, you know. She said, why does he want to move out? Well, it's just how it is, you know. But you won't be able to do that in Chobham. God's sake, man. You'll be there forevermore. So I come through Chobham and then round there and through... not narrow roads, but single lane roads with trees either side. It's all very nice. All very nice. Much preferable to driving on the motorway. The only thing was, because it was now like 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning. I was ever so tired last night. I'm not used to staying out till 3 a.m. I'm really not. Really not. I mean, I used to go out clubbing. I used to work till 3 o'clock in the morning at a place in Camden called the Black Cap. And then I'd dart home, get changed and go back out again. And we'd get to this club called Turnmills. The night was called Trade at like 4:30 in the morning. And we would dance until 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Honest, and I could do that, no problem. I'm having a laugh now, dear. I'm starting to wilt. I'm wilting. You'll notice the wilting poinsettia has gone now, boys and girls. I'm afraid it had to be... disposed of. Poor little poinsettia. That's my fault for not repotting it, apparently. Ray Reynolds said to me I should have repotted that. Very bad on my part. Didn't repot it and didn't water it enough. How terrible. Let me go back to your messages then. We're not getting through these messages here, are we? Just a moment, please. Yeah, so talk to each other. Don't sit there. That's how we got to that. So I'm sitting there DJing. They're all on their phones, even on the dance floor. Well, I say dance floor. There's a little stage in front of me there, and people like to come up there and dance after the show is finished. And they're dancing up there. And even while they're dancing, they're texting. They cannot put those bloody mobile phones down, can they? Oh, they can't. Good morning to Terry H. Won't let me tag you in. Oh, I don't know what that means, Terry. I don't know what that means. Won't let me tag you in. Oh, are you trying to tag me on something? I don't know. Maybe you need permission to do that. I don't know what that is. Good morning to Ashley. Good morning, Ashley. Now, Ashley, you used to come down to Sydenham. It's finished, I'm afraid. The Sydenham one is finished now, my darling. We're going to do one a month there, starting on the... one moment, please. Let me refer to my diary. Starting on Sunday, the 5th of February. Actually, I better put that on there, wouldn't I? Golden Lion. So the Golden Lion Sydenham thing. The karaoke we were doing there is no longer every week. It's going to be once a month, and it's also going to be open mic. So if you want to bring instruments down and plug them in, we're just going to do the once a month there now. All right, Ashley, so don't be turning up, dear, because little Chris won't be there, except on the Sunday, the 5th of February, okay? Good morning to Elaine. Morning, Elaine. A very happy new year to you, and a very happy new year to you as well, Elaine. Only one more day to go, isn't it, my darling? Yes. Good morning to Mary Wright, karaoke host extraordinaire S. I hope you don't put me, mind putting an S on as you're a lady, like actress. So you are karaoke host S extraordinaire S, if you see what I mean there. Oh, the phone's ringing. Good morning. Chris Reardon, United Kingdom Talk. Can I help you? I'm just doing a little show at the moment, sis. Eh? What do you mean, pause it? We're live, dear, live. We can't pause it, dear. Hi, sis. There we are. Excuse me, it's my sister on the phone at the moment. It won't be long. I'll have to talk to you later, darling. All right. I will ring you immediately that we come off air, Shell. I think people are expecting me to do a 10-hour show today. So I'll ring you straight after the 10 hours is up. All right, sis. Lots of love. Goodbye. Bye. There's my lovely, lovely sister. She's just ringing from the Jeremy Kyle show. They've just chucked her off for violence. Oh, yeah. Don't have a row with my sister. She's just been chucked off the Jeremy Kyle show for inciting violence. Well, she wasn't inciting violence. She was the violence. She started chucking chairs. Jeremy Kyle is now dead, I'm afraid. My sister has murdered him in his own studio. Good. Loudmouthed old git he is. oh, I beg your pardon. No, Wendy was not tweeting. It was a Facebook comment. He's replied to her Facebook. Are you a friend of Tony Blackburn's on his Facebook? His friends list is full up at the moment, unfortunately. Good morning to Callum. Good morning, Callum. All right, sir. Up to North. Who says, did you have a good Christmas? Wonderful. I had a lovely, lovely Christmas with my little nieces and nephews and great nephews and great nieces. Yes, I had a wonderful time. And, I think you're coming, aren't you, to Callum? Oh, hang on a minute. What's happened there? Oh, where's all... my messages have kind of jumped forward a little bit too far, I think. Let me just go back to those. There we are. One moment, please. We're trying to... There we are. Callum says, you should come to Nottingham. It's a good place. I could come to Nottingham. Yes, I could come to Nottingham. Yes, I actually was offered a job yesterday, a regular karaoke night in Norwich. But the problem there is it's going to be 3 hours to get there and 3 hours to get back. And it's just not, it's too much. It's too much. It really is. So won't be taking that one, I'm afraid. Anne Taplin says, don't want to live with my parents as they're in heaven. Oh, no, that's a long way to go, dear. Is there a ladder? Is there a lift? Have you got a lift all the way up to heaven? Good morning to Kevin Webster. Says, my radio called more in Worthing, Sussex. Kevin, Would you like to send that again? That doesn't make sense. My radio called more in Worthing, Sussex. No, can't work that out. Try it again, Kevin. Try that again, Kevin. Wendy says, that think her parents were glad to get rid of her. Oh, I don't mean that. I don't believe that for one moment, Wendy. I bet you was very popular at home, dear. Very popular. Adam says, most people, when they move for the first time, they live in within 7 miles of their family home. What, have you just done a bloody survey or something, dear? Adam, have you just... in a test, one out of 100 people surveyed, how far did the children live from their parents on their first move? Ding! Is it 7 miles? Let's have a look at the board. Top answer is... 7 miles. Well done. Adam's doing surveys this morning. Do another survey, Adam. Do another one. Good morning to Lily. Morning, Lily. Are you coming along to the karaoke tonight? It's Friday night. Karaoke tonight at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Anyone who's coming down there. Okay. Callum says, would you come to Nottingham for a few nights? I beg your pardon. That's very forward, Callum. I'd hardly even know you, dear. Would I come to Nottingham for a few nights? You think I'm easy? You think I'm easy? God's sake, man. I don't know how far it is. Let's have a look. Blacknall to Nottingham. This is for work, isn't it? Hang on. Blacknall to Nottingham time. Let's have a look. See how long that takes. Oh, by car. Oh, got hiccups. Oh, my nephew had hiccups in... My nephew, Jimmy Butler, international, he had hiccups in the church for the midnight service up in Woodall Spa. He was drunk as anything. I thought he was going to be sick in the church. How awful. Right, hang on. Does that say time? I'm trying to find the times. Oh, hang on. We might find something here. Miles, nautical miles. Why is it nautical miles? Oh, no. Don't know. Distance driving calculator. That might do it, mightn't it? It's 110 miles. Oh, I say. Does it say? Can't say a 58. Oh, here we are. Nottingham Bracknell at 55 mile an hour. You see, that's nearly 3 hours again, mate. It's nearly 3 hours to get there. You know, I think it's a little bit too far, to be honest, Callum, to go all the way to Nottingham and do one. So I'm sorry. Sorry about that, darling. All right, I think you're a little bit too far, Callum. Callum doesn't live here anymore. Is that a Cliff Richard song? Oh, that's Carrie, isn't it? That's Carrie, that is. Wendy says, one reason I love these shows is that it brings people together. And it does. I notice, you know, even when I'm not doing this, you all talk to each other, don't you? And isn't it nice? You can never have enough friends. But watch out for some of the friends, dear. Don't get ripped off by any of them. You know what people are like, dear? Yes, there we are. When are you going to have a New Year's Day? What are you going to have on New Year's Day? New Year's Day. New Year's Day. Where, are you asking me where I am, New Year's Day? Is that, what day is that on? Sunday, I'm off. I'm off New Year's Day. We might come up here and do a little show New Year's Day. All right? I haven't got anything to do New Year's Day, so we might come up here and do a little show. Let's have a look. Chris, replace Jeremy Kyle. No, I couldn't do that. I couldn't do that. I don't think I could do the Jeremy Kyle show, shouting and screaming at everyone all the time. No, thank you. I think he's quite a nice person. I bet he's a really nice person away from that, because that's a TV show. It's a show. It's a show. He will be probably putting a lot of that on for the TV cameras. I mean, how could you talk to people the way he talks to them and get away with it without having a smack in the mouth, dear? Eh? That's what's gone wrong with this world. There's not enough smacking in the mouth going on. Please carry on. Elaine says, Barry would approve of your war decor. Oh, perhaps you could send him a little picture. Perhaps you could send him a little picture of my wall decor. Actually, you know, if you're on a mobile phone or you want to do a quick screen, what is it, screen save? Screen, a screen grab on your computers. I'm going to pose for you now. Right, get ready on the buttons, okay? Ready on the buttons. I'm waiting for my little thing to turn around with a smiley face at the top. And then you can send this through to Barry and say, this man keeps talking about. Here we go. Take your picture now.
I've done it, mate. I've done it. I can't hold this picture on, though. Go and take the picture. Take it. I've done it.
There we are. There's a little picture. Please send that through to Barry Manilow and tell him that I'm always talking about when are we going to have more concerts from the great Barry. Even now. Stay. We can make love till the morning light. But not you. Well, maybe you. Let's have a look. Shania says, I love how you put off speaking to your sister. Of course. Of course. You are much more important. Much more important. Sister will be there later on. She'll be there waiting for my very important phone call to her. All right. Wendy says, apparently the BBC is now called the Blackburn Broadcasting Corporation. According to Tony, he owns it. Oh, I wish. We wish. He's back. He's back. Is it tonight? No, I think Tony Blackburn is back on Radio 2. I think it's tomorrow night, New Year's Eve, 8 o'clock. Then he's back on BBC London. That's the show you want to listen to. Tony Blackburn's BBC Radio London show, which is on Sunday, I think, at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And also on BBC Radio Berkshire, which is the one around here. And that's on Fridays. I don't think he's on today, though. Not sure he's on today. Good morning to Johnny Key. Morning, Johnny, who sends us in lots of little stories to read you. Thank you, Johnny. Morning, Johnny. Morning to Colin, who is one of the customers at the City of Quebec, where they are ripped off regularly now for door charges. Door charges and coat checks. Dear me. Adam says, I've just invited five of my friends to watch you this morning. Oh, well, you're going to have five very disappointed people then, I think, Adam. Definitely. Good morning to Ray Reynolds, who's in Woodford Green in Essex. Good morning, Ray. Ray's not been too well recently, but he's coming along now. I don't think he's coming to the karaoke today. I have instructed him. I have instructed him to take it easy, unless he has a miraculous recovery from his illness. And he hasn't had a very pleasant illness. I won't say what it was. But he's recovering now. And if you have a remarkable recovery tonight, then come and sing us a song. I do feel I ought to do a George Michael type song tonight. I like that Careless Whisper, but it goes ever so high, that does. Very, very high. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feeling, got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend, I know you're not a fool. I love that, don't you? Yes, love that one. Good morning to Daniel Rolfe, who's just down the road in Camberley. Good morning, Daniel. Danny Davis, we said good morning to already, I think. Poor old Carl was working last night, but he's not this morning. He's not back in work till 8 o'clock. And he works at a very late venue as well. How do you do that, Carl? I mean, you do get used to staying up until night time, you know, quite late, don't you? Good morning to Mark. Is this the live show of 2016? I never know with the live ones. I just come on and do them as and when, really. Really, Mark? You know. Let's have a look. Callum says, what did you think of my cousin Adam? Was that the lad you bought with me? Well, sorry, is that the lad you brought with you that time? Was it? Why, does he like me? Is there a chance that he might want to be with me for the rest of his life? Do I need to do my hair? Eh? Actually, does that bit matter? Now, I've got this stuff my niece has bought me. Right? And, oh, we're going to do this now. We're going to, oh, actually, no, do I have to open the window for this? It's supposed to hide your bald spot. Now, actually, I think I might, no, it's going to be difficult for me. No, I'll try it. Let's try it. Oh, it stinks. Oh, Christ. No, I better not do that in here. I think we need... I'll do a bit more. Hang on. Let's just try this a bit more. Hang on. I can't breathe in here now. Just a minute. Jesus. Oh, that can't be good. Oh! I'm not doing any more. Has that made any difference at all? My niece bought me this. And she said it will cover the bald spot a bit more. I mean, if Adam wants to take me out, I could try putting some of this off on so I don't look too old in front of his... How old is he? About 30. something like that. That'd do me. Yeah, it's quite nice. Quite nice, Adam. Did he put you up to that? Did he? Did he ask you to ask me what I thought about him? Is that what it is? Oh, God, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Bring him along. Bring him along. Let's have a little look here. Just a second. Where did we get to now? Mark Callum. Callum. Adam says you need Adam the Plumber Plumbing and Maintenance Service. What, to do my hair? Or is that an old message there? I've got a bit of a... Pete Burns, thank you very much. Pete Burns was the guy from Dead or Alive. You know that one. You spin me right round, baby. I can't get right round in the chair. Right round. Pete Burns, thank you. Elaine, morning from Worthing. Thank you, Kevin. I realise what you're saying now. Good morning from Worthing. That's a nice little place, Worthing. It's like almost on the south coast down there, isn't it? New Year's Eve, I shall be DJing, doing a little bit of DJing and putting the cabaret. Oh, it really stinks, this stuff. I'm going to have to open the window, but it's so cold out there. All I can taste in my mouth is this. My mate, Ronnie, he goes to, when he comes down the swimming pool with us, after he swims, he sprays and sprays and sprays his deodorant on, and it just gets down my throat. Oh, it's horrible. It really is. New Year's Eve, I'm doing a bit of DJing and hosting and working the sound and lights for the cabaret at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. I don't know my times there, actually, New Year's Eve. I hope it's not too late. It's not really a late, late night venue. It won't be like 3 a.m. or anything like that. But I do normally finish there at about 10 o'clock. Good morning to Craig Adams, who's doing his show on the Hospital Radio Castle Mead Radio. You'll see a little thing there. I think that's on this afternoon. Yes, it's on at 3:30, OK? So that's Craig Adams. If you have a little look in the messages, you'll see them there. Danny Davis says, how are you this morning? Not bad at all, thank you, Danny. Not bad at all, actually. We're doing quite well. Shall we open phone lines? If you want to call in, you can do so. If you're watching the show live, then the phone number has just appeared at the bottom. If you're watching the recording, there's no phone number appeared at the bottom because there's no lines to ring. So you can call in if you want to. 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477. Or you can use the Skype in, OK? If you've got Skype, my Skype username is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. So United Kingdom Talk is the Skyping, or there's a phone number as well, 020-8144-3477, okay? If you don't want to call in, or you're just happy to sit there and listen, that's all right as well. Entirely up to you, my darlings. Right, we have a phone call. Good morning. Who's on the line, please?
Good morning, Chris. It's Elaine calling.
Good morning, Elaine. How fantastic. Whereabouts are you, Elaine?
Sorry?
Whereabouts are you? Do tell us all.
This is Israel calling.
Israel calling. This is Jerusalem. Well, it's not Jerusalem, is it? You're in...
No. I'm south of Tel Aviv.
How fabulous. Do you know, I still... I don't know how old you are, I'm not asking your age, but I still remember the Eurovision Song Contest, which came from Israel twice.
That's right.
Yes, when the first time was the song Hallelujah, which is actually... one of my great nephew's favourite songs.
Really?
Oh, yes. And isn't it funny with children? They like a specific version of it that he's got on YouTube. The English version. Do you speak Hebrew, do you? There?
Yes, I do, yeah.
You can speak Hebrew. Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
I tell you what, because when I was there, you know, sometimes you go to other countries and that, and you can kind of look at these words, German or French or whatever, and you can just about work out sometimes what they mean, you know, especially like if it's like a bus timetable or something like that. But you go to the, you go to the bus station in Tel Aviv, and I had no idea what all those little squiggles meant.
Anyway, I just wanted to say a very, very happy new year to you and to all the viewers.
Thank you.
And I love your show.
Oh, thanks very much, Elaine. Tell me, what you know at Christmas, you celebrate Christmas?
No, we don't.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
We're just finishing the festival of Hanukkah.
Right, Hanukkah. So you celebrate Hanukkah. Do you have a special meal for that?
No, but we have traditional food that we eat. We eat jelly donuts, and we
Donuts.
eat potato pancakes. Yes.
Oh, right, okay. Oh, what are the potato cakes, did you say?
Potato pancakes. They're called latkes.
And are they the like normal size of a normal pancake, like perhaps what you get in America or something?
No. They're slightly smaller.
Little things. And what's in those apart from potatoes?
I guess potatoes, eggs, nothing special.
Well, it sounds very nice. When I come back to Israel, which I will do one day, I shall definitely come and have some potato pancakes with you.
Absolutely.
All right, Elaine, thanks ever so much for calling in.
Happy New Year to all of you.
Thank you for your kind words. Bye-bye, my darling.
Bye.
Cheerio. I think that was our first ever phone call from Israel. How marvellous was that? Yes. 0208 144 3477 is the phone number you'd like to call in this morning. All right, another one coming in here. Good morning. Who's that?
Good morning, Chris. It's Adam the plumber.
Good morning, Adam the plumber. Are you not out working, fixing a pipe or unblocking a very badly blocked up toilet somewhere, lovey?
No, I'm pretty badly blocked up myself today
Oh, you
with a bit of
sound
a
it as
cold.
well.
Yeah.
Dear, can't you put one of those rods up your nose and clear out all that gunge and snot that is affecting your vocal cords? You won't be able to sing, dear.
I know. I'll have to use one of those drain snakes up my nose.
How are you going to sing? Let's try it out now. I saw a mouse
Where? There
there
on the
on the
stair.
stair.
There on
We're
the
on the
stair, right
stair.
there.
Right there. Very, very good, Adam. Where were you going
I'm
New
very
Year's
butch
Eve?
today, dear.
Eh?
I'm very butch today.
I can tell that. Very, very, very butch indeed. God,
Yes,
just.
my message to you was, Chris, that you should employ the services of Adam the Plumber, plumbing and maintenance service to do your DIY and shelf putting up.
Yes, but it doesn't say shelf puttings up. It says, didn't we just turn you up a bit over here? One minute. I'm having a bit of trouble hearing you. I'm going deaf too. Oh, John, someone's trying to call in. Just to let you know, gang, if I'm on a phone call, I can't take another one at the same time, okay? So if you do try and ring while I'm talking to someone, it'll either ring or it will go to answer phone. Just to let you know that it's only me sitting here. I know sometimes I say there's hundreds of operators sitting in another room somewhere waiting to take your calls. Actually, I'm lying. I'm sorry to tell you I have lied. Bless me, Father, I have sinned. It has been, oh my God, about 35 years since my last confession. Father, I have lied to the listeners and viewers of United Kingdom Talk. So if I'm on a phone call, I can't take another one until that one's finished. Always, it's always like first to come, first served. All right. Yes, it doesn't say on your little van anything about shelves, does it, dear?
It does say maintenance services. So there you go. That is maintenance
Oh,
in
does it?
DIY. Yes.
Perhaps you could. Can you build sheds?
I can.
Ah, because I've got a lean-to on my house and
Yeah,
it is
that's right.
starting to disintegrate. It is starting to look. And I think it's something a little bit more. I don't know if perhaps I could have a little extension built there, brickwork. I mean, would that be more than £50?
It may just be a little bit more than £50.
55, 56, something like that.
Mates rates, let's call it 65.
£65. And you would, of course, charge VAT on that, wouldn't you, dear?
Oh, yes.
Thank God for that. I can't bear these people that say, oh, could you do it without the VAT? How do they sleep at night, my love? I
I
just don't
know.
know. You're waiting for that phone. Oh, hello, is that the tax?
Cool.
Oh, my God. Oh, what?
I mean, just think, Chris, poor Miss May, she won't be able to have a new suit or a new pair of shoes.
Oh, little Miss May, bless her heart. She looks wonderful in those leather trousers, doesn't she?
She does. She looks lovely.
If I would willingly sell my house and all its contents to purchase another pair of shoes from the lovely Theresa May. I am thinking of having a Theresa May picture behind us. What do you reckon?
You could do, yes. I think
I
you're going to
think.
need a wider length, wider angle
Oh,
lens
she's not
though for.
fat, dear. Don't you be
No,
saying our
no,
Theresa is fat.
no. No, I'm thinking of the wall space, dear. You're getting your
Oh, I see what you
wall
mean.
space is getting
Well,
full.
I think, I, do you know, I'm quite surprised that you can see all that bit over there. I think over there it would go. It would go either over there or down there, or Maybe down there. Or I could have a smaller one up there, couldn't I? I suppose. There. Yeah, so I think we need a little picture of Theresa May up there. But what I want to do, these lights are kind of... they seem to reflect on some of the stuff. So I think it might be a case of just moving them up a bit. And I'll play with that for a while.
You could move my cross from Malta up next to the cups and then put the picture there. And then once the furry eyeball comes down, put the globe up on that side and put the mirror ball to the right-hand side of your clock.
We're not going to go with a globe, we've decided. We're not going to go with a globe. We're going back to the mirror ball, which is over there waiting to be polished, Adam. It's waiting to be polished.
You're good.
So are you working today then or what?
No, well, meant to be, but my client hasn't rung me yet, so I'm still waiting for them to ring me.
You're not in a van somewhere then, are you?
No, I'm safely tucked up in bed.
Oh, you're sitting at home. Oh, in bed.
I have you in bed with me.
In bed? What, 25 to 11, dear? Well, oh, my word.
I'm laying on the bed with you, Chris.
Very, very slacking. Very, very slacking. You're the first person that's laid on a bed with me in over a year. Isn't that marvellous, dear? It really is. Have a lovely day, Adam.
And you, Chris. Bye-bye.
Cheerio now. Bye-bye. There we are. Adam the plumber calling in there from London. excuse me a minute. Oh, is that the one I just took? I'm going to get confused now. Getting confused. Just a second. Let me just... do that there. And that there. And that there. Good. There we are. Oh, there's another call. We're very busy on the phone today. Good morning to John. Morning, John. Morning, John.
Mr. Adam.
Oh, dear. Yeah. That's not very good call. How are you talking to me, dear? You're on a bus. Oh, have you stopped my have you stopped the show, have you? It's very noisy on that bus.
Yeah, a little bit noisy.
What sort of phone are you on? What phone are you on there?
HTC.
Oh, are you? Oh, okay. Well, good morning, John. Where are you? On your way to work?
No, just with the missus. Just on the way to Chingford to round to her granddad's.
Right.
Hello, she's awake. Hello, Chris. Got a little visitor that you haven't met yet.
Is this your little, is it boy or girl? Good morning. Are we on the speakerphone? Is the whole bus listening?
Yes.
Pretty much.
Is the whole bus listening? What's the name of your little one? What's the name of your little one?
Oh, the little girl, Kiwi.
Kiwi. Tell her Uncle Chris sends all his love and many, many hearts to her. All right?
And then funny enough, there's the wife that you ain't met yet.
Oh, bless. Well, I'll have to go because your phone isn't that good. It's really difficult to hear to you. All right?
No worries, mate.
Lovely to talk to you, John. Come and sing soon.
Will do, mate.
Bye, John.
Bye
bye.
Bye.
Anyway, that's one of our famous karaoke singers. He used to come down to Belushi's a lot when we were doing the Belushi's in London Bridge there. Some more messages here, boys and girls. Oh, I'm not keeping up with these this morning, are we? Good morning to Mandy. Mandy Mungaroo. Hello, Mandy. How are you today? Morning, Mandy. Adam says, Sir. Oh, we're not doing that one, Adam. Sir, no, we're not. We can't do that. We're not doing that. Lily says, we are at Gatwick to pick up our friend from Sweden, Les Swedes. They do very well. Sweden is now officially more popular than the UK at Eurovision. They keep winning it. I do like it when the Swedish host Eurovision. They certainly know how to do that. Very, very good indeed. Let's have a look. Mark, no. Mark says, did you hear about the media blackout saying 8 a.m. the announcement of the Queen's death, but it wasn't real? Yeah, don't believe these things. The amount of people on Facebook who put news stories like that and no one checks them out. They just quickly cut and paste them immediately and put them on the walls. And I don't think you did that, but it does make you look very foolish doing it. If you see a news story and oh, I'm not sure about that, then don't believe it. You know, there's so many. In fact, I've decided this year, I've written this down here. This year, here's a New Year's resolution. If you're kind of thinking around carefully and you're wondering to yourself, what can be your New Year's resolution? Here's a suggestion for you, right? On Facebook, do not cut and paste anything that says, please share or please cut and paste this. Don't do any of that. Do not forward anything for good luck, because it's not going to happen. You will not get any good luck. If you forward this, forward the peace birds or the love hearts or the rolling snowball, nothing is going to happen. You will not get any good luck, no forwarding, and no copying and reposting dodgy news stories without checking first. Or even, I'll tell you what, I came across quite a lot this year, people reposting old news stories where they think, oh my God, so-and-so has died. Well, they died 3 years ago, dear. They died 3 years ago. Incidentally, I am not dead yet. I'm not dead yet. I'm hoping to carry on for at least another 500 years, bringing you these little morsels of talking bits and pieces, okay? So, no, the Queen is absolutely not dead. No, I hope not. Anyway, we love the Queen. God save our gracious Queen and all that business, yes. Barry Manilow did a good version of Careless Whisper. I didn't hear it. Did he really? I haven't heard that. I should look up that on YouTube. Thank you very much. Callum says, what did you think of my girlfriend Emma? She's nice enough, isn't she, Callum? We like Emma. We like Emma. Lily says, if you're doing karaoke, no, only tonight, not New Year's Day or New Year's Eve. Karaoke is tonight, Lily. So that's Friday night from 8:30 tonight, my darlings, okay? Anne says, hide your bald spot, buy a wig. No, well, this spray stuff is supposed to spray on, dear. Actually, that does look a little bit better, doesn't it? I can't spray a lot in here because it's the fumes coming out of that are awful. I blooming die of suffocation before I get a head of hair. Good morning to Wendy. Have you got some tea there? No, I haven't. I've got no tea here, I'm afraid, to get rid of the taste of that nasty smell. Morning, Mary. Is it a free number to ring? Yes. When you say a free number, what do you mean? It's a London number. That's just a normal. It's not an 0800 or anything like that. What's the one? 0845. It's a completely free number, that is, that phone number up there. 02081443477. Okay. Claire has already been in and out today already. Have you done some shopping, Claire? I hope at Waitrose, dear. Hope at Waitrose. I told you about Sainsbury's. Did you see my Christmas shows at all? Sainsbury's were taking down the Christmas decorations on Christmas Eve. I mean, do us a favour. In the petrol filling station. I was disgusted. 11 o'clock in the morning, there's a bloke up a ladder taking down Christmas decorations. 12th night. You mustn't take anything. This will be up until the 12th night. So that's the 6th of January, OK? Good morning to my niece, Tracy Clifford, who's with us this morning. Good morning, Tracy. Callum says, does the number charge when you ring in? It's a London number, okay? So if you ring, it's not a free number, if you see what I mean. But if you ring London, it's the same cost as that. So it's just a normal phone call. It's a normal phone call. It's not a premium rate phone call. It's a normal phone call, all right? Good morning to Jerry. Morning, Jerry. Yes, and that's it there. We've got some birthdays to do. First of all, now, let me see this now. Where are we now? Now, here's something for you. Look into the sky. Look into the sky in this morning's Super Soar Away Daily Mail. Forget the ball drop. Ring in the new year with a comet sighting. Has any of you seen a comet? Those of you over sort of 40 will have done. 30 will have done. I remember seeing a comet years ago. It must have been about 20 years ago now. And it was in the sky for weeks. Was beautiful. We saw a comet. We did have a comet here. But anyway, comet 45P, Honda Mercus Pantagruel. foreign name of some sort, will appear to fly beside the moon. Oh yes, this comet makes its way back to the inner solar system every 5 years. Ah, here we go. While it won't be visible to the naked eye, all you'll need is a pair of binoculars. I think I've got a pair of those somewhere. Oh yes, I have up there, look. One there. I've got two pairs of binoculars, look. Two pairs of binoculars. Oh yes, they're really old. These are really old. Oh, there's a phone call coming in. Just a moment, please. Let's go to line 597. Who's on the line, please?
It's Callum from Nottingham.
Good morning. Callum doesn't live here anymore. Good morning, Callum. It's a local London number. You're so concerned about running up that little old phone bill. But am I not worth it, Callum? Just a few pence to talk to an old friend, lovey.
Yeah.
How are you today?
I'm doing good.
Yes.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you, yes. Talk to us, dear. Talk to us.
Yeah, I'm doing good.
Are you in? You're in Nottingham at the moment. Are you going out the weekend?
Yeah. I'm going down to Stoke for New Year's Eve.
Just a minute. Do you know that clock? So the clock seems extra loud this morning. Maybe I'll turn you up a bit. Where did you say you were going?
Going down to Stoke, New Year's Eve.
Stoke?
Yeah.
Is that a karaoke night, is it?
No, I'm going to see a band play down there.
Oh, right. What's the band called?
Top Marks, Mother and Sunday.
And what do they... Mates. Do they do their own stuff or covers or both?
They do covers.
Will you get a chance to sing with them?
No.
Oh, that's a shame. I thought you'd be going to a karaoke night down there, Callum. Something like that, my friend.
No.
Oh, what a shame. Never mind. So when are you coming down in January, aren't you?
January, yeah, we've had him.
What, well, you'll have a good time. Are you on a Monday or a Friday?
A Friday.
Friday. Oh, what a shame. Monday, it's cheap drinks on a Monday, you know, down there. In Central Station. Cheap drinks. Cheap, dear. Cheap.
I might try Monday then.
Yeah, Monday or Friday. But you'll enjoy either night. They're both sort of reasonably busy. Okay. Would you like to say hello to anyone while you're here?
Can't think of anyone.
Oh, no friends. Is it Callum Callum no mates? Oh, Callum, I'll be your friend. Hello?
Hello?
Have you gone?
Yes, I'm on. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can, yes.
Do you think it's a bad line?
Oh, it's not a bad line. We're here. You have a lovely day, Callum, all right?
Yeah, and you?
Thanks for calling. Bye-bye. Right,
bye.
There we are. Man of few words for you this morning. There's our lovely Callum for you, okay? Look, here's my binoculars. Look, now these... My dad was in the army years ago, and these are his old army binoculars. They're all metal. You don't get them like this anymore, dear. They're all bloody plastic things now. Look, all metal binoculars. I can see you through these. Look, oh, yes. Hang on, I've got to... I can't remember how to do this. I don't think they focus anymore. I wonder if I can have these repaired. Do these focus? I'll have to look at something outside. So I've got these, and I've got these little ones as well, but they haven't got the eyepieces on, so they're quite difficult to see. I don't think I can see anything through this. So I've got these binoculars. These are years and years old, and they've been sitting up there for ages. They're full of dust, actually. Oh, my God, look. Can you see the difference? I've just cleaned that one. Look at the difference. Absolutely caked in dust. It says, a comet is set to pass by the Earth on December the 31st, lighting the night sky with natural fireworks as the world rings in the new year. Ding dong, ding dong, and all that business. Yes, known as Comet 54, and then foreign word, the object will appear to fly right beside the moon, the crescent moon, and while it won't be visible to the naked eye, you'll need a pair of binoculars to catch a glimpse. So I shall be out with those. I'd probably be reported to the police, won't I? I should be outside my front door like this. He's looking in our windows. Why is that strange man looking in their windows? Oh, who's that old pervert with the binoculars outside my front door? I'm not looking at you, you old bag. Who wants to look at you? No, I'm not looking at you. No, I don't think so. So you might want to have a look at that. The only thing is, so that's next to the moon, on New Year's Eve, okay? Now, the only thing is, I have to say, on the on the occasions, whenever they say this on the radio, there's going to be like a comet or thousands of meteors going through the sky or anything like that. And I look and I never see anything. Do you? You know, when they had these meteor showers, I think twice a year, somewhere in the autumn, didn't they? They have these meteor showers and you can't see, I never see anything. Sometimes I'm driving along the motorway, and, oh, what was that? You know, that might have been a meteor had I have seen it. And I'm wondering if it's in my mind that a meteor has just flown across, or did it actually happen? Because some of them are so quick. The biggest meteor I ever saw was on Christmas night, and I suppose I would have been about 12 years old, and I was standing on the, maybe 12, 13, somewhere between 12 and 16. I was standing on our balcony where we lived in Roehampton, just looking out like that, and suddenly and there was a big bang. That's the only time I've ever seen a proper meteor like that. And it went on for seconds, you know, a bit like that one in Russia. The one in Russia that landed a couple of years ago. Do you remember that? Yes. Kevin says, how is your cat? Oh, she's all right, but I don't know. I think her head's a little bit gone now, really. She walks round and round in circles a lot and meow, 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 moans a lot. Misses the cat tray most of the time. But yes, so that's how she is at the moment. But yeah, she's still ticking over. Bless her up. Johnny Key says, how comes you've got a London directory number, Chris, when your studio is in Royal Berkshire? It's a Skype number. Anyone can have a Skype number. Costs you about £35 a year. And for that, you get you can choose the actual area where you want the phone number. I think possibly in another country. You could have a French number, I think. But have a look. Just look up Skype phone numbers and it'll tell you all about it. OK, so that's how I've got a London number there. Nice to talk to you on the phone, Callum. Elaine's still in her dressing gown. Oh, come on, Elaine. Well, this time of day, dear. 10 to 11 and you're still in a dressing gown. Come on, dear. Get moving, Elaine. My word. Is the phone line open after the show? No. It's not on after the show because I should be going swimming afterwards. All right, my darling. And Adam says, you need a team of people in there to handle all the millions of phone calls that are coming into the show now. Oh, yes. And make you tea. Well, where is Ronnie when you need him? Oh, he's down the hospital today. Now, what's he having done today? Because he has all sorts of things done at the hospital. He has these... Oh, I hope he's not watching. He has those things in his face. What are they called? Fillers. Don't grow old gracefully. That's what I say. Yes. Elaine says she's never seen a comet. Well, get yourself a pair of binoculars, Elaine. And don't stand outside anyone's house while you're looking through them because they start calling the police. They do. Hello? There's a lady looking through my window. Looking through the windows of love. Let me have a look. Right. Face to face. Well. Oh, you don't work on Friday. Oh, Elaine, what do you do for a job? I didn't know you worked, darling. What do you do for a job? Do tell us, Elaine. What's the time? Okay, we're going to do birthdays now. And then we're disappear today. Okay. Let's have a look where it's now. Today's birthdays. Oh, comments on yesterday's show. Nearly forgot that. One second. Where is it now? There we are. That's it. Comments on yesterday's show, my darlings. All from Simon. Hello, Simon, who says, regarding the six-year-old girl, there was when I was in Subway, was it last night in Subway? No, the night before. I was in Subway at 12 o'clock at night. It's like Subway as of part of a petrol station, the Esso petrol station in on Chiswick Roundabout. They have a 24-hour Subway in there, and I popped in there. There was a little six-year-old girl in there with her mum, but, you know, 12 o'clock at night, and I thought it was a bit late to have a little girl out. And Simon says, six-year-old girl in Subway at midnight, you're quite right. When I was younger, my mother says, if I'm not in bed by 9 p.m, go home. I think it's slightly different, Simon. I think it's a slightly different... You're a slightly different thing. Simon also says, you could do a Jonathan Ross-style show on TV. Oh, no, I wouldn't be swearing, dear. We wouldn't have any swearing. No, dear. But with proper guests like Linda Gray. Oh, yes. Who I met. Linda Gray. Sue Ellen from Dallas, I met a couple of years ago. Yes, megastar Barry Manilow, of course. And Irish Mary and Ray Reynolds could get involved somehow as well. Oh, we'd have to have them all on, dear. We'd have Roy. We'd have Irish Mary. We'd have Ray Reynolds. We'd have all our friends, dear. All our friends from the karaoke nights. Yes, we'd have Kelly Kim from the Sydenham one. We'd have Laura. We'd have them all on there. I would write to the chief executive of Sky or ITV, tell them what you're about and tell them to look at one of these YouTube shows. I did that last night. I read this last night and I'd sent a link to a couple of little TV people. You never know, dear. You never know. You've got to ask, haven't you? Got to ask. Although I've probably, at 53, I've probably left it a bit late now. Don't you think? Do you not think so? I think so. Someone says, I've put so much weight on. If I was in New York with a yellow Mac on, people would be shouting taxi. Taxi! Taxi! I got on the scales. It said one at a time. Please, I'll have to do some juicing. Oh, you're not doing that nasty juicing, are you? Oh, no. People put all sorts in there, don't they? Carrots and everything in the juicing machines. Dear, Mark is still in bed as well. Come on, Mark. Get up, dear. It's 11 o'clock. The day is going drifting away. In future, I shall be doing these shows at 6 o'clock in the morning and expecting you all to be up at that time. And still in her pyjamas as well. Dear me. Right, today's birthdays, and then we're going to disappear today, boys and girls, okay? Here we go. Happy birthday. Oh, look whose birthday it is. Little Ashley Kenyon. Now, she is the manager of the King's Head Theatre Bar, where I do the quizzes on Wednesdays. Not this week. No quiz this, not next week. No quiz next week. We don't think anyone will come because it's kind of just after the New Year. So no quiz next week, okay? Happy birthday today to, doesn't say how old you are, Ashley, but you're looking young and gorgeous. Happy birthday to Ashley. Pleasure to work with you, my darling. Happy birthday to Wayne Newman, who's 56 years old today. Happy birthday, Wayne. To Lang Mike. Who's, that might be the wrong way. Is that the, have I got that the right way round? It says on your Facebook, Lang Mike. It might be Mike Lang, I'm not sure. But 74 today. Congratulations, sir, and a big happy birthday to you. Happy birthday this morning to James Clark, to Mike Callum. Now, Mike used to be collecting money and door staff at the Black Cap when I first started there in 1980. It was either 87 or 89. I can't remember now. Happy birthday, Mike. Happy birthday to Ludo. Ludo, who's 36 today. Ludo, I worked with at Belushi's in London Bridge when I was doing the karaoke there twice a week. I loved it there. I loved it there. Happy birthday, Ludo. Happy birthday to Jason Scott, 44 years old today. Happy birthday to Pazaribo Airy. Now, where are you? Pazaribo Airy. Now, where would you be? Abu Dhabi. Okay, I think you're at Abu Dhabi. Are you at Abu Dhabi? Or Bahrain? Indonesia? Oh, you've been to all sorts of places, aren't you? Yes. Happy birthday to you, sir. And one more. At the bottom of the list, where we are now. Wayne Hingley. Happy birthday to Wayne Hingley. Here comes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right? Have a wonderful birthday today, boys and girls. I'm afraid, no, the phone line is not open after the show, my darlings. It closes them, I'm afraid, so I can get on with my sad daily activities. Apart from that, thank you very much for watching and listening today. Quite nice doing a live little... I can't get my mouse working now. Quite nice doing a little live show now and again, isn't it? Enjoy your Friday. And if you're doing nothing tonight, do join us for karaoke Friday and indeed every Friday from 8:30 at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross in London. Lovely big stage there with proper lighting and lovely sound system as well. And plus, you get to meet our characters, all right? Karaoke tonight at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Have a nice Friday. Thanks for watching and listening. Bye-bye now.